Hello and welcome to this model in Workbench Mechanical, in which I'm going to take an ordinary spring, a linear spring, and change it into a nonlinear spring. Inside ANSYS, springs, like this one, are usually represented with the combination 14 element. That is a linear element. It can support damping. It can support nonlinear damping with a second order coefficient. But it does not have nonlinear spring stiffness. The combination 39 element does permit it. What you're looking at here is a very simple model. I have a small cube. I'm going to move it vertically. This is a spring to ground, and the bottom of this thing is going to be fixed in space. So there's my solid. A simple little mesh. Here I have connections. I have a spring to ground. I've put in an arbitrary longitudinal stiffness because I'm going to change that. And I've located the bottom of this thing. I moved down to minus 200 millimeters in the minus y direction. And that was centered on the bottom of the lower face. And my movement on this thing is purely y direction movement. And I'm going to start off with it compressed, move back, and move it out to being stretched. That's going to change the length of the spring. Remember, I moved that down to minus 200. I'm only squashing at 90 millimeters, so it's going to appear the way a spring should appear. I solved the model through many sub-steps, and I've charted things such as force versus displacement and spring probe force. But let's see how the thing moves. I can animate its movement. Starts out compressed and goes into tension. So it starts out with a compressive force and goes into tension. My spring probe shows the force in the spring. It starts out, you can see, with a minus sign. It starts out in compression. It ends up in tension. And note, let me stretch this up. Note that the force deflection curve is nonlinear. That's at the spring. A force reaction here where the spring touches the body shows the same kind of curve. Let's look at that y direction force only. There we are. And you're seeing the same kind of curve that you see with the spring probe. And the trace in here reflects what I did with a commands object. I went to the spring that I created, and I did a right-click insert commands. Here's what I inserted. Let me blow that up so you can see it more easily. I changed the element type, and I have a pointer. It's underscore SID. That is a parameter in the ANSYS run that actually solves the model that temporarily, while it's creating this spring, contains the number of the element type and other properties, attributes, of this particular spring. So I can refer to it and change element type for the element type which has the number, which is underscore SID, a spring ID. And I changed the element type to a 39. By default, it would have been a combination 14. I've changed it to a 39. That's an element type that permits nonlinear force deflection behavior. I set an option so that I have displacement degrees of freedom, and then I set up a real constant for this particular spring, and I put in force deflection pairs. That's the way the spring element combination 39 is programmed in ANSYS. At minus 60 millimeters, in other words, when it's compressed 60 millimeters, the force is a compressive 100 newtons. At minus 30 millimeters, I have minus 20. I go through the 0, 0 point. At plus 30, I've stretched it 30 millimeters. I want 40 newtons. Note that's not the same as the minus 20. It's a nonlinear spring. And out, when I've stretched it 60 millimeters, I want it to be 100 newtons. There's my model. I put in that y deflection. I solve through all these load steps, all these deflections. And there's the force on the spring. There's the force where I'm touching the cube, and of course they should be the same values. So there's my force deflection curve. It's nonlinear, just like that point pair data that I put in. Let me go back. There I am. I go from minus 60 to plus 60 in the description of the spring. But note that I actually moved it from minus 90 to plus 90. Something to note. The way ANSYS is programmed, the combination 39 element extrapolates the stiffness beyond the beginning point that I put in and the end point that I put in. So it does not go flat, it extrapolates. The slope is continuous if I stretch it or compress it beyond the data that I've entered. That's a bit unusual in ANSYS because with many things that I put in with a tabular input, the curve goes flat when I hit the end of the range I defined. But with this spring, it continues along the same slope. The programmers had to do something, and here they chose to extrapolate beyond the ends of that spring stiffness data that I entered. Here's a chart then, and I can clean it a bit by showing only the Y direction effects. And that's a force deflection curve rather than force versus time. And the same thing here. And you see that same relationship. So that in a nutshell is a description of changing a linear spring into a nonlinear spring where you put in the force deflection data with real constant manipulations like this. Thanks for joining me.